Hey guys, in today's video we will do a detailed comparison between 2022 Ford Maverick and Ford Ranger, new as well as old. Also comparison between Ford Maverick and Hyundai Santa Cruz is available on our channel which you can also watch. Let's start today's video. Everyone with a smidgen of interest in the pickup truck industry is sizing up the 2022 Ford Maverick iterally. Its small dimensions, as well as its inexpensive price and standard 40 mpg city hybrid powertrain, make it stand out. However, knowing how distinct it is in size from other businesses' products is crucial to comprehending what the Maverick is. It would have problems standing out if it was too similar to the present Ranger in major dimensions. Fortunately, there's enough room between the two that the Maverick can carve out its own niche, as you'll see in a moment. What about the old Ranger, though? The tiny Ranger was the last true small body on frame pickup until 2011. Tacoma went midsize in 2005, the S10 was phased out in favor of the larger Colorado in 2004, and the second generation Frontier likewise enlarged in 2004. Ford, unlike Nissan, did not use the global midsize Ranger as a replacement, instead gradually nudging customers into lower-priced variants of its full-size and more profitable F-150 lineup. The tiny truck is back 10 years later, in a regulatory and consumer context that is placing pressure on fleet emissions and efficiency. While it is very different from the Ranger in terms of size, there are some fascinating parallels to be drawn. Let's see how big are the Maverick, Ranger, and Old Ranger. The Maverick is slightly shorter than the longest old Ranger and a lot shorter than the newer one, measuring just under 200 inches overall. However, it floats between the two in other important dimensions. The original Ranger was available in two wheelbases, single cab and extended super cab. The Maverick's crew cab only version falls in the middle. With the wheels pushed out wider and the small bed, it's clear that the old Ranger has a longer wheelbase than the new Ranger. It also features a wider track than the new Ranger, giving it a car-like, hunkered-down appearance. Let's take a look at the interiors. The Maverick is also higher than the original Ranger, indicating that the cabin will be significantly larger. That's understandable given that the previous Ranger was only available in single cab and extended cab super cab configurations. There was no way to get a Maverick in a crew cab form, which is the only way to get one. However, in terms of inside space, it's comparable to the new Ranger, with the exception of front headroom. When comparing the Supercrew Ranger to the Maverick on a like-for-like basis, the Maverick has a legroom and headroom advantage in the back. The Maverick has a total passenger volume of 100.3 cubic feet, compared to 97.6 cubic feet for the Ranger Supercrew. Remember that today's Ranger is also available as an extended cab supercab, which has a stubbier rear seat section that isn't particularly comfortable for passengers. So how much room do they have in the beds? Around back, the Maverick's major compromise to obtain a habitable cabin with a small overall footprint is visible. The bed is only 54 inches long, which is over 18 inches shorter than the 6-foot bed in both the original and new Rangers. However, thanks to a taller bed, volume is relatively robust, approaching that of the original Ranger. The optional tubular bed extender, which extends the enclosed bed space to an effective 6 feet, somewhat negates the length advantage. The FlexBed's tailgate also includes a half-down position, which makes it easier to transport big objects. Let's talk about payload capacity. The 2022 Maverick is comparable to the tiny Ranger in terms of volume, and its 1,500-pound payload rating is far higher than the base 2011 Ranger, much closer to the highest payload versions of the original Ranger, and, for that matter, many versions of the midsize pickups on the market today. This combination of qualities may appeal to users who need to transport larger but less bulky things, such as concrete sacks rather than dirt bikes. Let's look at the towing numbers. In terms of absolute towing numbers, the Maverick falls short, revealing one weakness of its unibody design. It can pull 4,000 pounds when properly outfitted, but the original Ranger could tow 1,860 pounds more. The larger, sturdier Ranger can tow up to 7,500 pounds. The Maverick's base towing rating, on the other hand, is higher than the original Ranger's. Let's compare engines. While the new Ranger is infamous for having only one powerplant option, a turbo 2.3 liter with 270 horsepower and 310 pound-feet of torque, both the previous Ranger and the new Maverick provide some options. The Maverick's base powertrain, a hybrid CVT combination, is unrivaled in terms of MPG, with up to 40 miles per gallon. However, Without an estimate on the more powerful turbocharged 2.0-liter EcoBoost Maverick's fuel economy, it's difficult to draw any further judgments about how it compares to its forerunner and larger stablemate. One thing is clear: the turbocharged Maverick's power-to-weight ratio is beneficial. Each horsepower has 14.3 pounds to pull in front drive configuration. The 168-pound penalty for AWD decreases this to 14.9. However, the lightest new Ranger, the 2WD Supercab, has a weight-to-horsepower ratio of 15.6 pounds per horsepower. For comparison, the regular 2011 Ranger single-cab two-wheel drive weighs in at 21.2 pounds, while the Maverick Hybrid weighs in at 19.2 pounds. The turbocharged Maverick should be quick, especially in all-wheel drive form. But it'll be interesting to watch if TorqueSteer makes an appearance in the EcoBoost front-wheel drive. So that's it for today. If you found this video informative, then give a like to this video, and also you can subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Till then, wear a seatbelt and drive safe. We will meet in next video.